So early on, the voice from our Māori and Pacific students in response to our visits out to local marae or to meet with our Pacifica community off-site was that they just didn't see themselves in this space. They walked through the door and they put on a mask. We didn't have a pōhere for our girls when they came into school. They were piped in with bagpipes. For our Māori students, it was wearing bandages to cover your tamoko or not being able to wear your tonga. And that, I just think that that's criminal. there are things that happen that are just, it's just heartbreaking.
We strategically appointed top staff, top Māori and Samoan staff through Teach First and through other avenues in order that our girls had role models in the school and that they could help us with that leadership.
One of our biggest things here is know our girls' story, and that when we put that in the forefront of our mahi and you look at through a Māori lens, it's the same concept. So if we're looking at them as individuals, we're looking and unpacking these all these things, but what works for Māori works for everybody. And I know everybody doesn't have a marae, but everybody has a tūranga waiwai.
Students here traditionally were sorted or stringed based on testing that was done over the period of one day, in fact their first day at school. We have been doing a lot of research, a lot of thinking, a lot of visioning around our girl to create a curriculum that's really responsive to our girl, who she is and what her needs are, her strengths, interests and talents. What would happen if you stop sorting and girls arrange themselves? And what does that look like? It looks like a series of hubs, things like te ao haka, succeeding in business, being a kaitiaki, Engineering Your Future, which is designed for students who've got strengths and interests in perhaps science and mathematics.
If we put more water in it, does that help us count the bubbles?
Yeah. Any ideas how much?
Let's add.
They are teaching it through the lens of mathematics, English, social studies, PE, science. They all teach through that similar lens.
Are any of you going to be choosing hubs for next year?
Yes.
Yeah, okay, what are we going with?
I have thought about doing te ao haka.
Are you?
The way that I went about it here was in meeting with the HODs individually every 2 weeks in order that we could really work on growing those leadership skills, because they are really key. They're the drivers, the engine of the school. The key focus was differentiation and was really strategically putting in place professional development for staff around working with behaviours in the classroom and differentiation of teaching and learning.
We have a high trust model where our senior lead team really trust each other, and that filters down to our middle team, middle leadership, and you know, and to the rest of the school as well. What I often remind the girls is that part of leadership is not a rank, it's a decision.
How much time are we giving them to shoot?
Yeah, it's really up to you guys. So you just want to go 40 seconds per house group.
I came here in year 9 and I was just blown away by the amount of support I felt by the staff. Mrs. Bentley shows up to all our games, all our staff show up.
It was quite a difference from like intermediate and stuff where everyone's a bit more standoffish. It felt like more of a team, more of a family, and you're clapping and the cheering, and it's quite heartwarming to see everyone being so supportive of each other.
We've made lots of significant appointments. Mm-hmm. Our head of sport, our chef, our careers advisor.
What program do you want to do at Waikato?
The physical education.
We have been very strategic with the non-teaching staff, just as much as we have with our teaching staff, because we saw they are crucial to a cultural shift.
Where would you stay, with whānau, or are you going to go in halls?
Yeah, I'll probably go into the halls.
Even myself, with my mentor, I went out and I tracked down who I thought would be the best person in the country to help me with that. And so I've had Dr. Anne Milne as my mentor and my appraiser. She's been working with me for the last 3 years.
The establishment of the Māori Council.
Made by Māori for Māori. That's kind of the kaupapa around it. It's important because a lot of Māori feel whakamā to share their own thoughts. They don't really want to speak out of the norm.
There is like equal opportunity for the girls to have a voice now. We hui all the time to come up with what's the next step, with what's the next step. And I love that they keep us on the pump all the time.
We're quite lucky that we have that kind of shared leadership where we can serve our students and the students can also show that leadership.
Who do you guys want to speak on the day?
You and another student.
My Samoan class wanted the Ia Lava Lava as a part of our uniform in school. So we gave our voice to our principal. This year we got that as part of our uniform.
Leaving in 2013 and then coming back as a kaiako. The biggest change for me is seeing the next generation rising up. It's seeing the narrative change. It's seeing Samoan being taught in this school. I never thought that that subject would ever be taught here. I never thought I'd see a brown teacher in the school. And I never thought that our girls would be able to have a voice, to be proud to be Pasifika.
We've stopped credit harvesting, we've stopped unit standard courses unless they are specific to practical subjects. Our Pacifica results for UE literacy have gone up 50%, and last year at level 3, our Māori Pacifica and Pākehā learners achieved the same percentage pass rate, so an equity of pass rate.
That's what equity looks like.